Mrs.
Mrs.
I don't know what you said, but now I'm a widow. My husband died.
Yeah. Okay, this is March 3rd, 1983. Joe Todd interview with Mrs. S.E. O'Gwen. Mrs. O'Gwen.
Yeah.
Where were you born?
Oh, where was I born? Man, I was born in Arkansas.
Arkansas.
Uh-huh.
What town in Arkansas?
Texarkana, Texas. Texarkana, Arkansas. It's Texas and Arkansas divide. There's Texas on one side and Arkansas on that side.
When's your birthday?
Oh, 14th of May.
What year?
That's right.
1912. Who was your father?
Who was my father?
Mm-hmm.
Harrison McCoy.
Harrison McCoy.
Mm-hmm.
Is he from Arkansas?
Yeah. He was there. Uh-huh.
Who was your mother?
Oh, mercy. Eliza McCoy.
What was her maiden name?
I don't know. Well, I know Eliza McCoy.
What kind of work did your father do?
Oh, my father mostly was a coal miner, truck worker, and things like that. He didn't farm, but she'd gotten too old for that.
How long did you live in Texas?
All my life, mostly. And the rest, I won't say all my life. I lived there long enough. Mm-hmm. But I lived in Oklahoma most of my life.
What part of Oklahoma?
Clinton, Oklahoma.
When did you move to Clinton?
When I moved to Clinton. Oh. Moved to Clinton. I think I moved to Clinton in 40, 41.
Were you married when you came here?
No.
How come? How were you when you came to Clinton?
Oh, not bad. I don't know just exactly how old I was when I come to Clinton, but I was working, you know, I worked at the sanitary and then stayed down and worked.
At the sanitary?
Uh-huh.
Is it still there?
No. They left here and went to Tallahena. And after they went there, well, they closed that out completely. Mm-hmm. They don't have no sanitary in Oklahoma.
They don't?
Uh-uh. They have, the doctors, you know, they have that new drug for tuberculosis patients. And when you get sick or something, they just give them that medication. And they don't have that in Oklahoma no more. But when it closed out, they closed out in Tallahena. Tallahena.
Tallahena. Yeah. Did you go to school in Texarkana?
Oh yeah, I went to school there.
What was the name of school?
What was the name of the school? I don't know the name of the school, but I went to school under Professor Higgins. There, out from Texarkana, a little town, Garden City. I was living there with my oldest brother and his wife.
What was the professor's name?
His name was Professor Higgett.
Higgett.
Uh-huh.
What did he teach?
What did he teach?
Yeah.
He taught school.
Oh, any certain subject or just everything?
He taught all up to high school, everyday school, you know, high school, just like they do now.
Was it an all-black school?
Huh?
Was it an all-black school?
Oh, yeah, that's all we had there. We didn't have no mixed dupes of school.
Yeah.
It was all black school. It's warm to me today.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Do you remember World War I, 1917,
1918? No, I don't remember that. I don't remember that. I've heard a lot of talk of it, but to remember it, I can't say I just remember.
Yeah.
I had a brother to go there, I think. Yeah, one brother went there, Mac.
Yeah, did he come back?
Yeah.
You lived in Texarkana in the 1920s?
Huh?
Did you live in Arkansas in the 20s?
Yeah.
What kind of chores did you do around the house as a child?
Oh, nothing much but play. Oh, you know, just the first one thing, I'd bring in water or wood or something, but that was all. We didn't have nothing particular to
do. You do laundry?
No, I didn't do no laundry no more than my sister and myself.
How'd you do your laundry?
We done it by hand and a rubber. That's how we did it.
You do it outside?
Yeah. Yeah, we did it
How about ironing?
Well, we ironed. Every time we washed, we ironed.
What kind of iron did you have?
Flat iron. That's right, it was a flat iron.
You just have, how many irons did you have?
Four.
Could you get a whole dress ironed before the iron got cold?
Could I get a hold of it?
No, could you iron a whole dress with one iron before it got cold?
No. You'd have to take the iron back to the fire and bring this one. Why? You couldn't iron a dress with one iron, a whole dress. You couldn't do that.
You have pleated dresses?
Huh?
Did you have pleated dresses?
Oh, no. We just had dresses. I don't know whether they were pleated or not.
I wondered how they get pleats in those dresses.
They put the iron, put it down, pleat it, and put the iron there, hot, warm, and press them down. Press them down that way with a warm iron, pretty hot iron, and put the little pleats in the dress and press them down. I don't know anybody ever just sewed and put it in there, but you could put them in there with your iron.
What about starch? How'd you make it?
Oh, they used starch. They made it and thinned it out and put that garment in there and squeeze it out and shake it and put it on a line, you know, dry in the window, and it was starched.
How'd you make your starch?
Well, we bought that starch in a red box, Argo, I think. Yeah, Joe, something like that, Argo starch in a red box. And then we take it and make it up with cold water. You know, make it thin with cold water and pour hot water in there and thicken it. See? And then when we got ready to put the clothes in there, you put cold water in it and thin it down the way you want it, see, so your clothes wouldn't be too stiff.
What kind of house did you live in Arkansas?
What kind of house?
Yeah.
I just lived in a house. They built houses there.
I mean, was it a wood house, frame house?
Wood house. We didn't have no bricks in it. I guess they had them, but I didn't know anything about them.
How big was the house?
4 rooms. It's all small enough.
Mm-hmm. How many brothers and sisters did you have?
Well, I had 3 brothers and 3 of us sisters at the time. My older sister left pretty soon. She married and went to Texas. Mm-hmm.
Ever hear about that big race riot in Tulsa?
Yeah, I heard about it.
What'd you hear about that?
Oh, I heard it was terrible bad. That's all I heard, how they killed white, and the white, they killed the black, and they killed the white. It was terrible, and when they hauled them off and just dumped them out. I heard about that back a long time ago. Well, it was terrible.
How many people were killed in that?
Huh?
How many people were killed in that?
I don't know. I wasn't there, but I heard about it. I was in Arkansas. We heard about it. That's the first, listen, that was the first destruction something that I ever really learned about was that, we said, well, it was a rout in Tulsa. I didn't know what a rout meant. But then some of them finally told me that meant it was killing people. I heard, I don't know how true it is, but I heard it was because of I don't know, I can't say that because I don't know that. But I heard they had a reason for having that route. Did you?
Well, I heard.
That's an animal call. I hate that blame thing. It isn't necessary for people to be in a place where there was patient or somebody coming in and out to interview you, and you have to listen to that done junk all the time, radio, over an inner call, hook it together, and play from 7 to 7 in the daytime. It's just disgusting. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I heard a lot of things about that race ride, but I didn't even know what a race ride meant. And I wonder why did they have that? What is it for? Well, I heard something, but I won't say it because I wasn't big enough or didn't have sense enough to understand.
Well, I heard it was about an elevator, laying elevator, and the black guy and the white woman. That's what I heard. I don't know.
I heard it was a white woman, a black man, and some kind of. And that's what started. That's what I heard, and I would look. Popped a mirror well in her face, and that's what the ride started by. I was still, I don't understand, but I heard that. And I thought that was about the awfulest thing ever. I thought, and now they're scraping the barrel. There's so much of that now, man, that you just wouldn't believe it.
Mm-hmm.
Disgusting to look at, disgusting to see, and it's terrible, man. Embarrassing. But you see, the Bible said, the last shall be first, and the first shall be last, before this world ends. And I would that gone if it ain't here. And it's just like boobs in the street, dancing down there. What I want to do. That's what I was supposed to do. I do what I want to do. That's a nasty thing and a dirty thing. But that's where it's going now.
Mm-hmm. In the 30s, how bad was the depression around Texarkana?
Oh, terrible bad, terrible bad, terrible.
How did it affect you and your family?
Well, it didn't affect my family so much. I was little because my daddy was a coal miner. He made coal, we call them. He raised his own vineyard, see. He raised peaches and pears and apples and grapevine. And we had everything to eat that's eatable, see. Because he raised it. He fixed it himself. And he went to the mines. Then we had to stay by ourselves until he come back. But he would prepare food there for us to have. We had it pretty well and all, but it wasn't cooked right. You know, it wasn't no woman. My mother died when I was born. And, my sister cooked. She done the best she could, but it wasn't like it should have been. But he was old, and he had to make a living, and he had to get out there and work. Mm-hmm. And then we had to stay by ourselves.
Where was the coal mine that he worked?
He worked up in the mountains in Texarkana, Texas, in Arkansas.
What was the name of the mine?
No, I don't know. It's a mine. All I've heard him say.
What he did was a miner. Low coal.
Coal, and hardly sold the coal. He made cross ties, he sold them, he worked with the railroads, you know, that's all.
He did? He made cross ties?
Yeah, he made cross ties, and he sell them, haul them, get somebody to haul them, but he didn't have no way to haul them, and take them down to the railroads and sell them. That's what he was done for a living.
Did your whole family come to Clinton?
No, my family mostly. Oh, no, I had a sister pass here last June. They all died out, not with me. Yeah.
Did you come by train to Clinton?
Did I come by train to Clinton? Let me see. I don't know. I think I came by bus to Clinton.
Bus?
Uh-huh. It wasn't a very good ride, but the bus at the roads wasn't nice, you know, but I came by bus to Clinton. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I came by bus.
I'm going to ask a personal question. You can't run the bus.
They rode, they had to get in the back.
Jim Crow law.
Jim Crow, that's it. Jim Crow, that's right. It was Jim Crow law.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, they were bad. That was terrible, man. But that's when the black were treated without the doctors. They were treated very cruel and mean. Yeah. And then one day, my dad went to the mill when the ground was sick. The ground was I'm went out there and was out there and he sent for somebody to send by somebody to come down to God and see if I was there and come down and get me. Because I was there and I was there and I was there and I was there. Man, I did the worst rat. God did it. Standing to stand. He was holding a curtain for old white man named Mr. Crow. Then we, me and my sister went to stay with my brother and his wife. And man, we was treated like dogs, railroads, everything. And then my dad took sick with that cold he had, and he died. And we sure went with him, but we didn't know. As far as she could, son, come on, brother, drink. And his wife didn't care, and she took his fight on the kids. When he'd go out drinking, see, and I was a man. But I told him on a Wednesday night, I said, I want you to know that as long as I live, I never expect to live under the roof of the house with you anymore. He said, yeah, y'all are getting old enough now to help me. And Robert, that's my young brother, he wants us. He didn't ask me down there. He don't know I'm coming, but I'm going. And so on Wednesday night, his wife was at the prayer meeting at church. And he sat on the porch. He didn't say that dumb thing, but I know that choked him. But I told him that I was going. And that Saturday, I was working for a lady from the north, Miss Price. And I was getting $3.25 a week. And that Saturday, when she paid me, I walked 25 miles barefoot to my brother's house. That ended it, too. They were so mean. I don't know, drinking, but they made that whiskey then. And called it white lightning or white or something like that. They made that stuff, and he would make it on the riverbanks. Man, on Saturday and Sunday, people get drunk and bite. I said, if the Lord just give me a little time, I'm going to get away. And I did. I got away, and I wasn't even there when he died. And he got killed by getting beaten up from a drunk. Man, that was a terrible life for black people. It was a terrible life.
You say you worked for Miss Price?
I worked for Mrs. Price.
What'd you do for her?
Huh?
What'd you do with her?
Oh, I worked in the house, cause yeah. So I stood up in a chair and washed dishes. Stayed with her. And I'd get up. I'd get up under the fridge there, they called it that. What the fridge there? It was an ice box or something. And it was up on the floor to be cooler, and then I'd get up under there. And that boy, she had a boy. His name was, I don't know, Lee or something, Lee Price. And he said, Mama, she hung down and I was I was bad though, but I wasn't bad about me today, just mischievous with him. And he was teasing me, I had time, but I found when I left out of the house, walking barefoot, I walked 25 miles, because I didn't know she was anything.
What part of Louisiana?
Huh?
What part of Louisiana?
I went to Haynesville. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Haynesville. Mm-hmm. I stayed in Haynesville with my sister till she got ready to come back to Arkansas. And she slipped off with me and went back to Arkansas, and I slipped off and went back behind her father. She gets so mad at me. I don't know why she was always that way, because I was spoiled when I was little, and she just got so disgusted with me. Mm-hmm. But they had to take whatever I put on, but I didn't have nobody to boss me around, you know. Man, I had a hard time. They don't need me to tell you I did, and I did. Had a hard time.
How come you came to Clinton?
I came to Clinton from Seminole. And when I left there, I came to Clinton because my sister went in.
Well, when
When did you first come to Oklahoma?
1927, I think.
When did you come? What part?
I come to Seminole.
Did you work there?
Yeah.
But what did you do in Seminole?
I worked for the NMS Roadwoods in that room now. And I worked 16 blocks there and 16 blocks back and worked for it more. I worked for the entire game of Seminole. I went there to work. But if the work was good in Seminole, when I went there, it was 5 or 6 Arkansas boys there. And I went to work in Seminole and stayed there a long time. But I didn't like it. And I thought my sister, I come up here with my sister.
How big was Seminole?
Seminole was too big, but it was getting bigger and bigger, you know, because it was talking about that older. Everybody was talking about the word over. Everybody wrote the word over again. But they left before I left this one. Yeah, and I stayed there until I came to collect my home. It was a long
time. You lived with your sister here, Pat?
No, she lived in Singapore, and I got a new one with them. W.T. Spears. He died from a heart operation, open surgery. And she died from my head to myself. She went to hemorrhaging.
What were you doing when the Japanese bomb came out?
What was I doing? But I was scared. I was so scared. Maybe I don't know what would I do. What was I doing? I'd be on the morning when I saw the town I lived in. I'd be on the working for the shop town. I'd be working for the shop town. I'd be working for the same thing, you know. I'd work for that.
What did you do in the same town?
I'd work the same thing. I just worked on the ward. I worked out there for 18 years.
When did you leave the sanitary?
Not too long ago. I think I got sick in 62. I had a stroke in 62. Then I had to stay at home. Couldn't go back to work. I had, on that side, yeah, I've got a lot of it out, but my throat was stuck. My throat was intriguing. But that's when I had a stroke, 1962. I haven't done much since.
When did you meet your husband?
Tulsa.
In Tulsa?
Mm-hmm. He come out here and stayed at the hospital, and he's going for the doctors. Because you don't want a doctor to know them. He was going to the army or something, and we hadn't had, most of we had is RN nurses. And they were teachers. They told me, man, they even told us how to prep the patient for surgery. See, we learned us how to give blood, you know, how to take care of the patient on that board with blood, how to cut, wash that needle when the blood get out, we pull it and then snatch the needle out. We would like to do that. We had to do it. And we learned to do it without going to school, but after that, we went to school right down there in Lincoln's, but the hospital, we went to school there. There were nurses on there, old nurses on there. Mrs. Kelly taught us. Went to school right there, and we were taught. We learned how to give down shots, coordinates, one oath, and one so small pieces of stone. We were learning, and we were taught that. We were taught how to do it for the arms, medicine. We were taught how to do it to the hand of the government, how to carry the hand of the government, how to stand. You know, it's an understanding. Now I've worked all my life. I've had to. I didn't have to work for it. I had to do it.
could do. He went my house to you getting the one out. $2 a week. I think it took me about 2 weeks to get that clock, but I got it. Man, I'll tell you, I'm this one person, I don't know, I can tell you everything about myself. No, it's terrible. The way you got to live then.
64, that passed the Civil Rights Act. Where you standing at?
64, man, I don't know why. I guess I didn't make memories back, or whatever done, said, and done, I had to go to work. I think that's when I broke down as soon as I did in life, because I had to work, and sometimes you get so tired and worried stuff on your mind, you lay there thinking you're sleep tonight, and you lay all night and what they could do. Got so much on your mind, and somebody, man, I bet.
You want to tell me a little about your childhood, or?
Oh, well, I don't know. I know about my childhood. My childhood was a tough life. See, he had everything that my daddy had. He got that. Well, that made him pretty well up in the world. When he took his money, he bought a saddle, rode around a big gold rim saddle, and white work. She'd be mad and bitter with me. Oh, when he'd come home, and sometimes he'd beat her up. So that was the biggest man you ever seen.
His wife beat you, and he beat her?
Yeah, he beat her sometimes. Sometimes he just tell her, you know, he'd go up and beat her. But then the other people didn't do anything to me. They'd get after me and back to them. Why do you all do that shit like that? Why do you should let them come to Sunday school? Why don't you send them to church? I send them to church when I can. I don't have to. I have my house clean. You don't have to come around when you're trying to other people. And she sang a big number. She was thrown to a rock, and she had $2. Now, he was a lawyer. And I went back there, and she said, I said, you're $2, I'm not going to make you work here and get you a job. I'm going to find you a job. She said, I'm not going to let you do this. This old man is old. And as long as we've been married, this is the same old furniture. So he had bought me a furniture, I'm going to get you a job. So she got me a job at Klein's Cafeteria House, a big cafeteria. I was the head cook. I was putting over the hammer with big paintings and putting them up in the cafeteria window. But it was a man there named Joe that washed dishes. He picked up my big pans. I couldn't lift it up. I was living with it. And he lifted them pans up, and them gals at the window would take them out and set them on the cafeteria counter. See? And then I'd get the ham, which covered that cup, and brown and fix, and set it up there, and the girl would set that brown to the audience, you know. Six chickens every day for dressing. They were dressing to go with it, gravy to go with it. I cooked all the best. I cooked the bread. I cooked right there for 6 hours at that time. I went to Colorado. And I didn't just leave to go, but I went with the spirit. I took another girl. Now, they took a baby girl. She was kind of sick. And she wanted me to go with my mother. That's the good thing. Come right back to the house.
We have good reviews.
So, man, I'm telling you, I'm married up to those beautiful trees, which was over.
It's awful. That's fine.